people here in just 225 square feet here, as opposed to only 11 people downstairs, which is 1,000 square feet. So big thanks to Sumanda and Somanda for making this happen, and I think so long away. I am Prabir. Currently, I am working as Vice President in JP Morgan Chase. I am a BPM evangelist. This is an architect in Pega, and my job duties are to doing digital modernization in JP Morgan asset and wealth management using business process management tools. So what I am going to talk about today is a little bit different topic. So I am going to talk about process automation in industry using industrial robots. So once you talk about automation, these are the things typically comes into your mind. Obviously AI, we already had two great sessions on AI related topics from Arindamda and Nilidhi. You talk about robotic process automation, robotic desktop automation, machine learning, deep learning, predictive analytics, adaptive analytics, neural network, cognitive computing, all these. But where those are really used, it's not only the software where you use these techniques to automate the process. There is also a big industrial automation happening where these techniques are also used in the form of robots. So this is where the robot is coming, industrial process automation using robots. And these days robots are sophisticated enough to use all these technologies inside the robotic brain to really automate the process. So I'll go through a lot of examples. So I was going through this article and it catch my eyes. Industrial robots are marching into US factories at a record pace. So that actually shows that how this industrial automation is really getting in pace. Key points from that story is that in US in 2018, the industrial robot usage was increased by 7%. Even though the unit is little less, you can see there are around 40,000 units used in industrial automation. The numbers are less, but it is really picking up. And historically, the industrial robots are primarily used in automotive industry to automate things, but now it is spreading across all the different industries, including pharmaceutical, automotive components, electronics, and everywhere. So next I'll cover industrial robots. What are they? Where they are used, and why we should be using industrial robots to automate different business process. So, to set some context, these are the primary six different type of industrial robots, and they are used for different things. The first one is Cartesian robots. You might have seen like knitting machine and all this stuff, and even 3D printing, those types of robots are used. Then you have articulated robots. We'll see these are heavily used in the automotive industry. I'll give you some example. You have Delta robots, those are also used in food and pharmaceutical and electronic modules. You have SCARA robots, which are also used heavily in automotive industry to move things around. You have cylindrical robots to move things around in a very limited space. And you have polar robots, which can go in any direction. Now, to give some statistics, you can see in 2016 quarter one, if you add up just 32% and 35%, almost 65% of industrial robots were used primarily for automotive, and the other industries are also coming up. They are used in semiconductor, plastic and rubber, life science, pharmaceutical, all these industries. And these are some companies who are building these industrial robots: Fana, Yasika, ABB, all these companies. Now, where these industrial robots are used? If you take the snapshot of US, this is the robot that are primarily used. Lot of robots are in Michigan, Ohio, Indiana, and all these. This is a chart which shows robot density. What is robot density? That means for every 10,000 of employees, how many robots are working. So it's like not robot actually, it is a cobot. So you can see South Korea is leading that one. US, I think, robot density is around 200, so every 10,000 employee you have 200 robots. And this is some interesting fact that mostly in red states in the United States, the robot density is way higher than the blue states. This is another chart of worldwide robots usage forecast, and you can see by 2025 it is going to be a $67 billion industry. primarily in industrial robots. Then it is coming to commercial also, like your personal robots. Heavily used in military also. The next world war probably will be fought by the robots, not the humans. Why you want to use industrial robots? Obviously good quality. Once you program it correctly, you can do the repetitive tasks again and again. Your waste reduction, and they don't have emotion, so you don't need to deal with promotion, you don't need to deal with compensation, all this stuff. They have faster life cycle, if properly maintained, they can work 24 hours, improved workflow safety, reduction of labor cost, reduce store space, integration within the systems. Now, the main topic today, industrial robot-based automation. There are a lot of examples. In the interest of time, I'll go through one. And before I go into a detailed case study, these are some of examples where industrial robots are used. The picture you saw is the car manufacturing factory picture for Tesla in Fairmont, California. So they are using almost 160 robots to automate their car manufacturing. And these robots are doing this heavy lifting of all these car components. And they have even named those robots as the characters of X-Men movies. They have Xavier, which stands in the entrance line and moving parts. They have Iceman, Wolverine, Beast, Storm, Colossus, doing all different types of work. This is another picture. This is a drone-based bot created by Acrobotics, which can identify wheels in your field, and then it can spray all these things to actually kill the wheels. The next picture is from Amazon, where they are using robots to actually pack your order, reducing the human. And they are doing a good thing to make a cultural change. So for them, it's not human versus robots, it's human plus robots. And they termed it to be a cobot, not robot. And this is a picture from Walmart, where they are using this kind of robots to actually scrap their flow rather than human beings. And very soon you will see all the stores, this kind of robots-based cleaning is happening. Now this is a big case study where robot-based process automation is happening in car assembly line. So you can see here, even before this, I just given the example of when the final manufacturing is happening, even before that lot of things happen, that also has lot of robots. So if you see here, the car body is ready, only the car body. It is coming in your production line number one. The windows are taken away. There are human beings also. In the entire picture, you will probably see 100 of robots used as opposed to 10 human beings. So the doors are taken out by robots. It is going there and getting assembled. The door part, inside door, whatever electronics and everything you have. So after taking the door, you are moving ahead. And they are taking out the door, and in number 3, they are actually installing the dashboard. So once the dashboard is done, that is fully by the robot. On number 4, the robot is installing windscreen. After that, in 5, they are actually assembling the drive line and chassis. And number 6, they are actually putting the body, this body with the chassis to have the car ready. Number 7, they are actually installing the car wheels. Number 8, they are now putting back the windows. And then number 9, they are actually doing testing 9 and 10. And number 11, they are doing all functional tests. Number 12, they are doing rain tests to check whether there is any leakage or anything. So you can see here almost most of the part of this car manufacturing is actually happening by robot rather than human being. These are more details about what is happening in each slave and what kind of robots are used, what kind of dressing mechanism is used. Now this is a quick SWOT analysis. What is this SWOT? SWOT is strength, weakness, opportunity and threat. Whether uses of industrial robots is good or not. So strength wise, we already discussed a lot of advantage of using robots. Weakness is, still it is costly, but in them the worst way, right? The cost of this kind of robots or AI is gradually, dramatically going down. Opportunity is a good opportunity to use industrial robots to automate things. It can improve your productivity, it can bring more automation, it can be mass adoption, and artificial intelligence powered robots can even help in machine learning tasks. threats. Obviously, we are scared about this robot because we think they might take our job away. Even there is research over there. Sometimes they can malfunction, and as I was mentioning, sometimes the AI can also introduce bias. This is another study to just check whether our thought process of whether industrial robots are going to take away our jobs or not. At least right now, based on this study, it says when the industrial robot usage has increased, your US unemployment rate, which is represented here with red, is actually gone down. So usage of robots and usage of employment actually increased together. This is wrapping up. This is a quiz for everyone. If anybody know or understand what these robots are, anyone know any of these robots? First one is Chloe. This is used in Best Buy to give you DVDs. This is a robot used in California called Cali Burger. The robot is actually making the burger for you. This is a robot, fast robot, which can recognize your expression, and it's called Pepper from SoftBank. And this is a robot used in residence in Los Angeles. It is called Wally the Butler. All home services are being done by this one. The robot actually delivers you food. You can actually order coffee from downstairs Starbucks via this robot. And this is what the reality is. The world is coming with robots. That's it. Thanks, everyone.
Thank you, Prabir. So we'll move on to the next round. So it will be a round table. So there is no table, most of all. So we will have five chairs over here. So we can take a couple of minutes to set up. Meanwhile, those who would like to do the registration part, we can come here.
Thank you.